Hola, yo soy el señor Norton y bienvenidos a otra lección del Español 2. En esta lección vamos a hablar de los stem-changing verbs. Now, you may have heard them called boot verbs in the past. Boot verbs is just a cute little way to remember when those changes that we're going to talk about today happen, to remember that it doesn't happen in the nosotros and vosotros. We'll talk about that more in a minute. I tend to call them stem-changing verbs because that's what they are. Boot verbs is more of a cutesy name, but we won't argue about that right now. Let's just get right to the verbs. Now we have four verbs we're going to focus on today. These four verbs all come from the lessons that we're studying right now. Those four verbs are almorzar, to eat lunch, empezar, to begin or to start, entender, to understand, and repetir, 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 repetir. If you didn't figure it out, that means repeat, to repeat. Okay, first let's talk about what a stem is. Let's start by looking at the verb almorzar, to eat lunch. Now, you'll see that it ends in AR. Remember that all verbs in Spanish end in AR, ER, or IR. That's the part that usually changes when we do our conjugating. What we're left with, if we were to drop that ending, is called the stem. Now, in this case, when we learn the verb, we see off to the right an O to UE. Now, sometimes it might say O colon UE or O greater than UE symbol. That shows us that in the stem, the O is going to change to a UE when we start conjugating it. Okay, let's take a look at how this one changes. By the way, what did almorzar mean? I only mentioned it briefly. It means to eat lunch or to lunch. Okay, so in a stem-changing verb, we're going to change this O to a UE. Now, there are different stem changings, different ways that stems change. We'll talk about that in a moment. So let's look at this one. Almorzar. How would you say I eat lunch? Well, if we change the stem, it won't be O anymore. It'll be UE. Almuerzo. Yo almuerzo. Yo almuerzo con mis amigos. Yo almuerzo todos los días. Me gusta almorzar en. ¿Dónde como el almuerzo? Me gusta almorzar en Barros, en la pizzería Barros. Ok, tú, where do you eat lunch? ¿Dónde almuerzas tú? Again, stem change. Also, font change, it looks like, but whatever. I don't care, as long as you're understanding this. El, ello, usted. How do you say he lunch or she lunch? Or if you're talking to a teacher, a police officer, somebody you respect, a boss, somebody older than you and stuff, how would you say he, she, or usted eats lunch? Almuerza. Almuerza. Ella almuerza con su amiga Liliana. Él no almuerza hoy. ¿Dónde almuerza usted? ¿Usted almuerza con los otros profesores? Okay, nosotros. Now this is where it gets into the boot. We eat lunch. We don't stem change here. Okay, don't stem change in the nosotros. Almorzamos. Tengo que hacerlo un poco más grande. Perdón. Ahí está. Nosotros almorzamos. Nosotros almorzamos todos los días. Almorzamos. Now, I know I told you that we don't do vosotros really in here because we don't come in much contact with people from Spain here in Arizona. But let me throw this one on here for you just in case you're interested. Perdón, almorzáis. Almorzáis with an accent over the A. Last one, ellos, ellas, ustedes, almuerzan. Almuerzan. Okay, almuerza, almuerzas, almuerza, almorzamos, almorzáis, almuerzan. Actually, if we're using the vosotros, we'd probably end up saying almorzáis. That's okay. Let's go on to the next one. Let's go on to some practice, I should say. Okay. Almorzar, por ejemplo. ¿Cómo se dice I eat lunch with my friends? I eat lunch with my friends. You got it? Something like yo. Let's make that optional. Yo. If we didn't have it, we capitalize. Almuerzo con mis amigos. Yo almuerzo con mis amigos. I eat lunch with my friends. How would you ask somebody with whom do you eat lunch? ¿Con quién? What would it be? ¿Con quién? You eat lunch. Almuerzas. Now, if you wanted to, you could throw on the tú. And if you're doing accents, Alt-163 is the safest bet there. ¿Con quién almuerzas tú? With whom do you eat lunch? Okay. Next one, empezar. You'll see it's an E to IE stem changer. Oh, I'm sorry, I misspelled that. Empezar. Empezar, it's an E to IE stem changer, so we're going to be changing that E. Yo, I start, empiezo. Tú, what do you think that would be? Do you get the stem change there? Empiezas. He, she, usted, what is it? Empieza. Nosotros empezamos? No, señor. We don't do stem changing in the nosotros. Remember that. Empezamos. Perdón, otra vez. Not enough space there. Uy. Empezamos. Vosotros, if you want to learn this one, empezáis. Uy. Did it again. It's early in the morning. Fingers aren't working quite right. Empezáis. I'll just blame it on that. Ellos ustedes. What would that be? Stem change or no? Sí, señor. Empiezan. Again, what does empezar mean? To start or to begin. Okay, so how would you ask somebody, at what time does school start? Well, at what time? ¿Qué hora starts the school? ¿Qué hora? It starts. Empieza la escuela. ¿A qué hora empieza la escuela? La escuela empieza a las 3. La escuela, perdón, a las 3. Bueno, puede ser la universidad. La universidad empieza a las 3. Mis clases empiezan a las 7. No, perdón, empiezan a las 8. Mis clases empiezan a las 8. ¿A qué hora empieza la segunda hora? La segunda hora empieza a las 9:15, más o menos. ¿A qué hora empieza? Empezar. Okay, next verb here, entender. Entender, to understand. To understand. So how do you say I understand? Well, it's an E to IE stem changer. So it's end and E to IE. Entiendo, entiendo. ¿Entiendes la lección? Sí, entiendo. Or how do you say I don't understand? No entiendo, no entiendo. How do you say you understand? ¿Entiendes? He, she, or usted understands? ¿Entiende? ¿Nosotros? Stem change? No. Perdón. ¿Entendemos? I'll fix that template someday, maybe. ¿Entendemos? ¿Vosotros? Well, if you want to know the vosotros, it's and it's Alt-130. ¿Entendéis? Ellos es ustedes. Back to the stem changing again. What is it? Entienden. ¿Ellos entienden la lección? Sí, ellos entienden. Y nosotros entendemos también. Pero él no entiende. ¿Tú entiendes? Todos nosotros entendemos. To understand. Okay, let's hit an example here. Let's keep this one easy. Most common way this gets used. How do you say I don't understand? No entiendo. ¿Cómo se dice do you understand? Alt-168 for the upside down question mark. Do you understand? Well, it's as simple as one word. ¿Entiendes? You understand? Okay, almost done here. Last one. Repetir. Now this one's just a basic E to I stem change. Repetir, of course, means to repeat. So E to I, and it's going to be the second one. So I repeat, repito. You repeat, repites. He, she, or usted repeat. Él, ella, usted. What is it? Repite. We repeat, repetimos. Y'all repeat in Spain, repet, and it's all 161. Repetís. And ellos, ellas, ustedes, they repeat. Back to the stem changing again. Repiten. Okay, oh, let me leave it there just for another second for you. Repito, repites, repite, repetimos, repetís, repiten. Okay, going back to an example. How would you say, can you repeat the question? Oh, we'll use a different stem changer. ¿Puedes repetir la pregunta? Okay. How would you say, I repeat the words to memorize them or to learn them by memory? Yo, which is optional. Rep, I repeat, rep, say it. Repito, oh, perdón, repito las palabras. Yo repito las palabras para aprenderlas de memoria. Okay, yo repito las palabras. Okay, well, I guess that's it. We have these four verbs. Let's see them one more time. Almorzar, what does it mean? To eat lunch. How do you say they eat lunch? Ellos almorzan. Next one, empezar, what did it mean? To start, good. If you say good, I assume you knew it. How do you say class starts at 8? La clase empieza a las 8. Next one, entender, what does it mean? To understand. How do you say we understand? Entendemos, no stem change. And last one, repetir, what does it mean? To repeat. How do you say we repeat the words? Repetimos las palabras. Okay, I promised three, I told you guys three things to write at the end of each, or three things to do on your little practice sheet at the end of each lesson. Today, those three things, just write one original sentence, a complete sentence, using three of these four verbs. In other words, number one, pick one of the four verbs and write a sentence about it. For your number two response, pick a different verb and write a sentence using it. And for your third response, for your third practice, write a sentence using yet another verb. Okay, so you'll end up having three different sentences using three of the four verbs. That's the end of this lesson. Stem changers with four new words. Buena suerte y vamos a hablar muy pronto. Chao.